Sairam children, so today we are back with the English period and we are going to do our new voices today, right? So today children will be starting with chapter 3 in new voices. We have already completed our chapter 1 and chapter 2, right? Now we are going to start with chapter 3. Children, in our last chapter, that is the poem that we learned, we saw there was a little boy in the poem who could not see. But was he sitting and crying over it or bothering about it? No. But then he used his other senses and he could very well relate to the nature. He could relate the colors to nature and he described them very beautifully. The same way, in this lesson that we are going to learn today, we are going to see a small girl who cannot walk. She needs a wheelchair to move from one place to another, but that doesn't bother her. And she is always happy and smiling and always ready to help others. She goes out of her way to help a friend in finding a cat for her. So children, let us see how she helps her friend in the lesson, Catch That Cat. So today, we'll start with chapter 3, Catch That Cat. Children, before we begin with the lesson, we will be learning the new words that are coming in the lesson. So let us start with that. I will read out the words to you and you're going to repeat it after me 3 times. Yes? The first word is L-I-T-E-R-A-T-U-R-E, literature. L-I-T-E-R-A-T-U-R-E, literature. Next, M-O-N-S-T-E-R, monster. M-O-N-S-T-E-R, monster. R-A-C-E-D, raised. R-A-C-E-D, raised. S-T-R-E-A-K, streak. S-T-R-E-A-K, streak. F-L-I-C-K-E-D, flicked. F-L-I-C-K-E-D, flicked. S-L-I-D-I-N-G, sliding. S-L-I-D-I-N-G, sliding. C-R-E-A-T-I-N-G, creating. C-R-E-A-T-I-N-G, creating. N-A-U-G-H-T-I-E-S-T, naughtiest. N-A-U-G-H-T-I-E-S-T, naughtiest. S-T-R E-E-T-S, streaks. S-T-R-E-E-T-S, streaks. D-I-S-A-P-P-E-A-R-I-N-G, disappearing. D-I-S-A-P-P-E-A-R-I-N-G, disappearing. C-O-M-F-O-R, T-A-B-L-Y, comfortably. C-O-M-F-O-R-T-A-B-L-Y, comfortably. C-U-D-D-L-I-N-G, cuddling. C-U-D-D-L-I-N-G, cuddling. I-M-A-G-I-N-A-R-Y, imaginary. I-M-A-G-I-N-A-R-Y, imaginary. B-A-R-G-E-D, budged. B-A-R-G-E-D, budged. W-H-E-E-L-E-D, wheeled. W-H-E-E-L-E-D, wheeled. D-A-R-T-E-D, darted. D-A-R-T-E-D, darted. F-R-I-G-H-T-E-N-E-D, frightened. F-R-I-G-H-T-E-N-E-D, frightened. S-C-O-L-D-E-D, scolded. S-C-O-L-D-E-D, scolded. F-U-Z-Z-Y, fuzzy. F-U-Z-Z-Y, fuzzy. W-A-I-L-E-D, wailed. W-A-I-L-E-D, wailed. P-A-N-T-I-N-G, panting. P-A-N-T-I-N-G, panting. S-P-R-A-N-G, sprang. S-P-R-A-N-G, sprang. P-I-T-I-F-U-L-L-Y, pitifully. P-I-T-I-F-U-L-L-Y, pitifully. B-U-G-G-E-D, bugged. B-U-G-G-E-D, bugged. Understood, children? So you have to learn these new words that are coming in this lesson, right? Now let us go to the next. I'm going to give you some words and we are going to frame sentences out of these words. Let us see what the words are. Barged into. Barged into means entering with noise. Entering forcefully with noise. Raced. Moving fast from one place to another is race. Scolded. Your mother scolds you, right? When you don't do your studies or you don't do your homework or you're doing a lot of masti, your parents scold you. So that is scolded. Panting. Panting is breathing heavily while running or doing some work. If you breathe heavily, that is known as panting. Sliding. Moving on a slope. Moving on a slope is known as sliding. Right, when you go to the park, you climb on a slide and you come down sliding, right? Yes. Now these words we are going to use to frame sentences. Shall we start? Tom barged into the room crying. Tom barged into the room crying. Raced. Raju raced to the park to play with his friends. Raju raced to the park to play with his friends. Scolded. Mother scolded Priya for not doing her homework. Mother scolded Priya for not doing her homework. Panting. Anu was panting as she climbed up the stairs. Anu was panting as she climbed up the stairs. Sliding. Anil came sliding down the hill. Anil came sliding down the hill. Okay, children, understood? Now shall we move ahead? Yes. Children, this story, this lesson that we are going to do is written by Tarini Vishwanath. She is a lady who is very fond of children's literature. That means she used to write nice imaginary stories with imaginary villages and fuzzy monsters for little children like you. Okay, now let us read what she has written for you. Shall we start reading the lesson? But children, pay attention when I am reading. Don't look here and there or do any masti. Concentrate and listen attentively to what I am reading. Okay, so shall I start? Yes. Dip Dip was the naughtiest child in school. One morning as Dip Dip was getting ready for school, her little friend Mimo barged into her room. Copy is lost, Mimo wailed. Copy was Mimo's cat. Don't worry, Mimo, Dip Dip said. You go to school. I will look for Kapi. How do you think Mimo lost Kapi? Dip Dip put on her uniform. She packed her bag, picked up her lunchbox, and let her brother wheel her to the bus stop, like he did every day. Okay, children, now let us see what words have come here, what new words have come here. The first one, barged into. In the third line, it is there. One morning, as Dip Dip was getting ready for school, her little friend Mimo barged into her room. So, what is barged into? Entering suddenly and noisily. Kapi is lost, Mimo wailed. So, what is the meaning of wailed? Cried loudly. Crying loudly is called wailed. And then, last line, the last sentence, let her brother wheel her to the bus stop like he did every day. Let her brother wheel her. What does that mean? Let her brother wheel her. That means to push something that moves on wheels. As I said, it was a small girl who could not walk. Dip Dip is that girl who could not walk, and her brother used to take her on a wheelchair to the bus stop for going to school every day. Okay, now let's see the next part. He left her there to wait for her school bus and went off to his own school. As soon as he had left, Dip Dip raced off. She wheeled her way up and down the streets calling, Kapi, Kapi. She looked behind houses, she looked inside the dustbins, she looked under bushes. Kapi was nowhere. Where do you think Kapi would have gone? Have you seen a brown cat around here? Dip Dip asked some people who were digging the road. His name is Kapi. No, we haven't, they replied. Have you seen a brown cat around here? She asked an old man drinking tea in a t-shirt. His name is Kapi. No, I haven't, he replied. Dip Dip now came to a road that went up a little hill. She wheeled herself up, panting a little. Have you seen a brown cat around here? She asked a woman hanging clothes to dry. Is that him? The woman asked, pointing. Okay, children, now let us see the words here. As soon as he had left, Dip Dip raced off. So what does raced off means? Rushing, moving hurriedly from one end to the other. Next. Come down. She wheeled herself up, panting a little. Yes. So what does panting mean here? Breathing heavily. So what did she do? Once her brother left her at the bus stop and he went to his school, she started moving from here and there on the streets looking for the cat. And she started calling out, Kapi, Kapi. She looked behind houses, she looked inside the dustbins, she looked under the bushes, but Kapi was nowhere. Then she saw some people digging the road. So she asked them, did you see Kapi? Did you see a cat? They said no. She asked an old man sitting at a tea shop, did you see a brown cat? They said no. Then she went up a hill panting. She wheeled herself up. I told you she cannot walk. She was using a wheelchair. So she wheeled herself up. And she asked a lady over there who was hanging clothes to dry, did you see a cat here? And the lady said, is that, she pointed somewhere and she asked him, is that him? So now, let us go through what we have read. I'm going to read it once again. You all are going to look at the lesson in front of you on the screen attentively. Listen and look at the lesson on the screen, okay? So it's chapter 3, Catch That Cat. Dip Dip was the naughtiest child in school. One morning, as Dip Dip was getting ready for school, her little friend Mimo barged into her room. Kapi is lost, Mimo wailed. Kapi was Mimo's cat. "Don't worry, Mimo," Dip Dip said. "You go to school. I will look for Kapi." "How do you think Mimo lost Kapi?" Dip Dip put on her uniform. She packed a bag, picked up a lunch box, and let her brother wheel her to the bus stop like he did every day. He left her there to wait for her school bus and went off to his own school. As soon as he had left, Dip Dip raced off. She wheeled her way up and down the streets, calling, "Kapi, Kapi." She looked behind houses. She looked inside dustbin. She looked under the bushes. Kapi was nowhere. Where do you think Kapi would have gone? "Have you seen a brown cat around here?" Dip Dip asked some people who were digging the road. "His name is Kapi." "No, we haven't," they replied. "Have you seen a brown cat around here?" she asked an old man drinking tea in a t-shirt. "His name is Kapi." "No, I haven't," he replied. Dip Dip now came to a road that went up a little hill. She wheeled herself up, panting a little. "Have you seen a brown cat around here?" she asked a woman hanging clothes to dry. "Is that him?" the woman asked, pointing. "Now, children, tell me, whom was the lady pointing to? Could that be Kapi the cat? Has Dip Dip found out Kapi?" We will be seeing all these things in our next class. So we are going to stop here. We are going to do till here. And does Dip Dip find the cat? Is Dip Dip able to help a friend out by finding the cat? We will see in our next class. Okay, children. For today, we are going to stop here. And the remaining part of the lesson, we'll do in our next class. But I have some exercises for you. We are going to do some exercises related to the part we have covered till now. Yes? So, the first is write the opposites of. I have some words that have come in this lesson till now. You have to write the opposites of these words. You are having your book and pencil in front of you, right? So get ready, write down the words, and you're going to write the opposites of these words, and then we will check whether you've written it correctly. Yes, children? Let's start. Lost. Go. Are you writing? Very good. Up. Behind. Inside. Under. Done with writing this? Write the answers. Ready? Shall I tell you the answers now? Yes. Opposite of lost is found. Go is come. Opposite of up is down. Behind, in front of. Inside, outside. Under, above. Yes, children, have you all written this down? Done? Very good. So let's go to the next exercise. Now you're going to write the past tense of certain words that we have seen in this lesson. Go, think, pack, pick, look. So the past tense of go is went. Shall I start? Yes, the past tense of go is went. Past tense of think is thought. THOUGHT, thought. Past tense of pack is packed. Past tense of pick is picked. And past tense of look is looked. So past tense of go is went, think is thought, pack is packed, pick is picked, look is looked. Yes, children, completed. Have you all done with the writing? Okay, shall I move ahead? Yes. Now, did you all listen to the lesson attentively? Yes, then you must be knowing the answers to this. So let's see whether you are able to tell me the answers for this. Dip Dip was getting ready for Dash when Mimo came crying. Just write down the answer, children. No need to copy the whole thing. Just write down whatever you feel is the answer. Then I'll tell you the correct answer. Yes, Dip Dip was getting ready for Dash when Mimo came crying. Second one, Dip Dip offered to find Dash. Dip Dip offered to find Dash. Third one, Kapi was Dash in color. Kapi was Dash in color. Have you written the answers for this? So shall I tell you the answer now? Okay. First one, Dip Dip was getting ready for school when Mimo came crying. Dip Dip was getting ready for school when Mimo came crying. Dip Dip offered to find Kapi. Dip Dip offered to find Kapi. Kapi was brown in color. Kapi was brown in color. Done? Okay. Now, children, just some questions and the answers for that. There's no need for you all to write this now. Just listen attentively and see what the answer is coming for this. Why did Mimo come to Dip Dip early in the morning? Why did Mimo come to Dip Dip early in the morning? Do you know the answer for this? Why did Mimo come to Dip Dip early in the morning? Let us see what the answer is. Mimo came to Dip Dip early in the morning as she had lost her cat Kapi and she was very sad. Mimo came to Dip Dip early in the morning as she had lost her cat Kapi and she was very sad. Next, what did Dip Dip tell Mimo and what does this tell you about her? What did Dip Dip tell Mimo and what does this tell you about her? Let us see what the answer is. Dip Dip told Mimo not to worry. She reassured her friend that she would look for Kapi. Dip Dip told Mimo not to worry. She reassured her friend that she would look for Kapi. What did Dip Dip do after her brother left her at the bus stop? What did Dip Dip do after her brother left her at the bus stop? Let's see the answer. After her brother left her at the bus stop, Dip Dip went to search Kapi. She wheeled her way up and down the streets looking for the cat. After her brother left her at the bus stop, Dip Dip went to search Kapi. She wheeled her way up and down the streets looking for the cat. List the places where Dip Dip looked for Kapi. List the places where Dip Dip looked for Kapi. This surely you must be knowing. Yeah, do you remember which are the places Dip Dip went to search for Kapi? Yes, so let's see. Dip Dip looked for Kapi behind houses, inside dustbins and under the bushes. Dip-Dip looked for Kapi behind houses, inside dustbins and under bushes. How many people did Dip-Dip ask if they had seen Kapi and who were they? How many people did Dip-Dip ask if they had seen Kapi and who were they? Let's see. Dip-Dip asked about Kapi from some people who were digging the road. Then she asked about the cat from an old man drinking tea in a tea shop. After that, she asked a woman hanging clothes to dry. So, Dip-Dip asked Kapi from some men who were digging the road. Then she asked about the cat from an old man drinking tea in a tea shop. After that, she asked a woman hanging clothes to dry. Okay? Okay. Now some fun time. Now, I'm going to show you some animals, names of some animals and their movements. Now, you have to match the animal with their movements correctly. Basically, you're going to do the following. You're going to match the animals with their movements correctly. Okay? Yes? So, in animals, you have beetles, birds, fish, rabbits, monkeys, horses. I repeat, beetles, birds, fish, rabbits, monkeys, horses. And movements you have swim, climb, crawl, trot, hop, fly. Swim, climb, crawl, trot, hop, fly. Now you are going to do the matching. Write down 1, then dash and write down A, B, C, D, E, F. The correct match you write there. And do it for all the 6, and then I'll tell you the answers for this. Done. Shall we see the answers? First one is beetles, and beetles is crawl. Second is birds. Fly, F, fly. Third is fish, A, swim. Fourth is rabbits, E, hop. Fifth is monkeys, B, climb. Sixth is horses, D, trot. Done? Okay. Now children, we have done alphabetical order in our class 1, class 2, even in our KG, right? Now what is alphabetical order? Alphabetical order is the order of letters in the alphabet. When we arrange the words in alphabetical order, we arrange them according to the first letter of the word, right? If there are some words given to you, you see the first letter of each word and arrange them alphabetically, right? For example, here see alligator, book, deer, girl, jump, shining. So we have taken the first letter of each word and then we have arranged the words in alphabetical order, right? A comes first, so alligator, then B, book, deer, girl, jump and shining. Now, what if the first letter of all the words are same, then what do we do? So if the first letter is the same, then we check on the second letter. If the second letter is also same, then we check the third letter, right? So the air, allow, always. In all the three, the first letter is A. So I will take the second letter. I, L and L. So which comes first? I. That's why I've written A first. Now in the next, L, and here both the words second letter is also same. So let's see the third letter. Allow, L is the third letter, and in always, W is the third letter. So which will come first, L or W? L. So allow will come now and always will be last. Okay. Now which will come first, blue or blunder? In both these words, BLBL, the first two letters are same. So what should I do? Then I should see the third letter. So what is the third letter in blue? O. And the third letter in blunder is U. Now tell me which comes first, O or U? O comes before U. So I will write bloom first and then blunder, right? So both the first and second letters are the same here. So we will look for the third letter. And since O comes before U, bloom will come before blunder. Clear, children? Yes, did you all understand this? Yes. Now I have some exercises for you. You are going to arrange them in alphabetical order. Okay. So I have a set of words for you. You're going to arrange them in an alphabetical order. You just write the answers. You don't have to copy the question. The question will come on the screen. You arrange them in alphabetical order and write the answers. And then I will show you the answer. Carpenter, tailor, engineering, budget. Now tell me which word should come first, which will come second, third and fourth. So just write the answer in your book. Okay, shall I show you the answers now? So the first will be butcher, carpenter, engineer, tailor. Yes, B comes before C. So first comes butcher, then carpenter, then engineer, then tailor. The next one, marigold, jasmine, rose, sunflower. Marigold, jasmine, rose, sunflower. So, if I write it in alphabetical order, it will be jasmine, marigold, rose, sunflower. Jasmine, marigold, rose, sunflower. Next one. Purple, orange, yellow, pink. Purple, orange, yellow, pink. Write down the answer. Okay, shall I give you the answer? Orange, pink, purple, yellow. Orange, because O comes before P, so orange first. Then there are two words with first letter P, so I have to see the second letter. In pink, I is the second letter. In purple, U is the second letter. I comes before U, so pink will come first and then purple, and yellow, Y comes after P, so yellow in the last. So the order is orange, pink, purple, yellow. Let's see the next one. Measure, measles, maize, mayor. Wow. All the first letters start M. All the first letters are M. Measure, may, measles, maize, mayor. So if the first letter is same, what should I do? I should see the second letter. So see the second letter. May, second letter is A. Maize, second letter is A. Mayor, second letter is A. So there are three words with A in the second letter. So which should come first? But I have to see the third letter. Now see the third letter. In May it is Y. In maize it is Z. In mayor it is Y. Y comes before Z, so I have to take may or mayor. But which one will I take? May or mayor? May or mayor? The three letters are same, so I have to. There are only three letters in may, so I will take may first. Then I will take mayor. Then I will take mays. Now afterwards, what should I take? Measure or measles? See the second letter, E and E, same. So go for the third letter, A and A, same. Again, so go to the fourth letter, S and S, same. So go and see the fifth letter. What's the fifth letter? In measure, it is U. In measles, it is L. So which should come first? Measles. L comes before U. So measles will come. And in the end, the last word will be measure. So let's see whether answer is right. Yes, it's may, mayor, maize, measles, measure. May, mayor, maize, measles, measure. Done, children? Understood? Have you all completed? Okay. Now, children, there's a homework for you. What is the homework? You have to learn and write the new words that we learned three times. You have to learn them also and write each word three times in your book. And also, whatever, how much ever we have done till now, you're going to read that much part of the lesson. Right? So how much ever we have done, you're going to read that much part of the lesson. Okay, children? So learn and write the new words three times and also read the lesson till where we have done. Understood? Okay, so see you in the next class. Bye.